Good evening from the nation's capital. I'm David Aiken. Thank you so much for watching. We've been tossing and turning all day. Start with the big news in Quebec, the debate last night. But no, we're going to start in battleground Alberta because we, of course, have a premier, a leadership race we're waiting for. And now we could have an election in the spring. Shane Saskew is the Wildrose MLA for Lac-La-Biche, St. Paul, Two Hills. He lives in Two Hills. He's also his party's caucus whip. Shane, it's great to have you on the program. And I mentioned that you're the whip in addition to your critics' duties because whips are usually in touch with the mood of the caucus. And let me ask you, dramatic few days, obviously, in Edmonton. What's the mood on your side of the legislature?
Well, we're very excited to get going in terms of pushing forward with our agenda. The government currently is completely paralyzed. So Wildrose is focusing on identifying the priorities of Albertans and pushing forward and demonstrating that we will be a government in waiting if Albertans give us the responsibility. So while the PCs are infighting, we're working hard and building our relationships across the entire province, and the mood is very positive on our side.
I was on some of the Wildrose buses through the 2012 campaign. That was the campaign that you were elected in. And I sensed that certainly the polls then, as you know, ahead of that election were very good for Wildrose. Didn't turn out to be on election day. And there was certainly a sense of confidence among Wildrose candidates at the time. Maybe a little overconfident, I don't know. And that's why I wondered about the mood now. We could be into what essentially is a long election campaign looking to next spring instead of 2016. And this time around, if it is going to be an election next spring, give me your sense of how Wildrose, once again, riding high in the polls ahead of something, is going to approach things.
Of course, we'll never take anything for granted. But what is encouraging is that we finally broke some ceilings that we haven't broken even since before the last election, broken some ground. It takes a little while after having a government that's been in power for 43 years. People are used to voting for them. They're used to showing their intentions that they're going to vote for them. But now that they're giving us a serious look, we're very, very encouraged. Of course, polls go up and down, so we're just doing the necessary groundwork to provide a viable alternative in the next election. But currently, you know, the PC party is in complete disarray. At the same time, we're going to do everything we can to make sure that we're doing the necessary groundwork to provide an alternative next election.
Well, and I sort of want to maybe pick up on that point, because obviously the crisis that precipitated the premier's resignation started with her judgment about how to spend taxpayers' money. The expensive flight to the South Africa, to Nelson Bella, $13,000 for a couple of nights of hotels in Toronto and Chicago, things like that. Beyond that, beyond what the premier was tagged with, what are some of the things you'll be telling Albertans that the whole government, the whole PC party of Alberta, how have they displayed lousy judgment?
Absolutely. It's not just the premier. It's across the entire PC party. After 43 years of being in power, there's a culture of entitlement. There's a culture of corruption that is pervasive. We've seen throughout their years of governing under Premier Redford, cabinet ministers using government planes to attend party fundraisers, the complete and utter abuse of taxpayer dollars. And every single caucus member has supported their budgets, where they've drug our province into $21 billion of debt, where we're going to have to pay interest payments of $280 million a year, despite having record revenues in the past 5 or 6 years. It's going to be very difficult for them to change their path, but at the same time, we in the Wildrose can't sit back and criticize. We're putting forward positive policy proposals while they're infighting and they're doing their power struggles to show that we can govern in 2016 if Albertans give us the responsibility of doing so.
There's often a saying in politics, when your opponent's in trouble, like they're in trouble, just basically get out of the way and let them basically jump over the cliff. Politically speaking, what is some of the instructions to your caucus to sort of keep your head down, or is it really time to just put your, put your foot on their throat and press down?
Well, of course, I did that in the last election. You always have to keep putting your foot on their throat and finish your opponent. But at the same time, right now, it's really just gradually growing our party, recruiting our candidates, raising money, and doing all those types of things to ensure that we are ready. At the same time, it's unfortunate that instead of governing this province, the PC party has been in constant power struggles and infighting. We have the opportunity here, and of course, we're going to do everything in our power so that we don't waste it.
Well, it would be historic if Wildrose could bring down the most successful political dynasty, I think, in Western democracies. It would be something else. Shane Saskew, thanks so much for joining us, and good luck in the next few weeks. Looks like a wild ride in Alberta, at least.
Thanks for having me.